there's two cases here. So let's say the graph does have a clique of size m. Then what will happen is the following. So it contains exactly one vertex that corresponds to a variable in that clause. And what we also know is, because we constructed the graph this way, that we cannot have two vertices connected here in this graph where there's a conflict. So what we cannot have in this graph, for example, is one vertex that represents not x2 and another vertex that represents x2, because we avoided this in the construction. But this directly shows us how we can satisfy this Boolean formula here. So if we have a not x2 here, we just set it to 0. So we could just set this one to false so that not x2 becomes true. Then this clause here is satisfied. And also this one over here would be satisfied. And x1, that's a separate variable, so we still so we can set it as we want. And we could also set this one to false. So we have x2. And we can set that to false so that not x2 becomes true. So that becomes true. That becomes true. That one here is false. Over here, we have not x2 as well. So there's no conflict here. x1, we haven't yet talked about x1, but we can just do the same thing. We can set x1 to false so that the whole thing not x1 becomes true. We've set it to false. And we haven't even looked at x3. But all of the clauses are already satisfied. And that's actually the cool thing to notice here. X3 is also not contained in the clique. So the vertices in the clique tell you how to set the variables so that the Boolean formula can be satisfied. So what if this graph here does not have a clique of size m? Well, in this case, it means that we have one clause group which is not contained in the clique. And if we have one clause group that is not contained in the clique, this means that there's no vertex in the clause group that has connections to all of the other vertices in the smaller clique that we're looking for. And that means, due to the way we constructed the graph, that every vertex has a conflict with another vertex in the clique. So if there's no large clique, this means that every assignment of true and false to the variables will lead to a conflict such that at least one of the clauses cannot be satisfied. So then the Boolean formula does not have a satisfying assignment. So now that we have this reduction, we know that clique is NP-complete, which of course makes Bob a little unhappy. So now what about vertex cover and independent set? Are those problems NP-complete or are we not sure yet?